There are a few other characters in Ramayana who also play some good role in among the Rakshasis. So they mix it up, etc. But there are, they expand the role a bit. See, we saw in Valmiki Ramayana, she is contemplating suicide, etc. It's not an attempt at suicide. But in Samatha Ramayana, she wants to commit suicide. After Ravana comes in, threatens her, etc., she says, "Now I have to die." Like now she's saying, and now the only thing that Trijata was sleeping, that Trijata is not sleeping. She's telling Trijata, "I want to die," and she's requesting her to please arrange for firewood so she can burn herself. And Trijata is a seasoned counselor, looks like. So she doesn't say, "You should not," and all that. She says, "I'll go," and all that. Comes back and says, "There's no firewood."
So the woman passes.
There's no firewood. Like that. Then later there comes a situation that actually Ravana makes Sita believe that Rama has been killed. Yuddham. So now one of these Ramayanas, Ravana, then she immediately decides that now they have to die. There's no question of my living now. He has been killed. But this is far more serious. This is not. Earlier she said, "Okay, no firewood." Now too, she may not listen to that excuse. So Trijata apparently tells her that I'll also die along with you. There's no point my living also. But first I must tell my father and come. Hold on, I'll tell Vibhishna and come back, we'll both commit suicide. She probably feels like that. Then she goes and tells, comes back with information that Vibhishna has told that nothing has happened to Rama, you don't need to commit suicide. Like that. She plays a key role. Like when in the battlefield suddenly she hears Lakshmana's conch, suddenly she knows Lakshmana's conch. So she said to Jetta, find out why is he blowing like this. So she goes and finds out, comes back, she says, Indrajit has been killed. Lakshmana has killed Indrajit, that's why it is conch. Like that. Information she will pass on. Then, this is Ramcharitmanas. Ramcharitmanas. In fact, when before the final duel of Rama and Ravana, etc., she is very worried. She has to talk, Sita. Now, this will be between Rama and Ravana, etc. Sita is telling her, tomorrow, kind of thing. She is extremely worried because she knows Ravana cannot be defeated. He is invincible. How to kill him? There's no way to kill him. He has got. She knows all that, so she is very worried. Now, what will happen to Rama? This is too much, etc. She is thinking, she is talking to the Trijata. Says, don't worry. Rama will kill him. He will kill him by shooting him through the arrow through his heart, etc. So, yeah, she plays a very key role. The Kakavan Rama, that is the Java, Indonesian Rama, Ramayana is supposed to be a classic in poetry of Indonesia and Javanese people who, it's supposed to be kind of set in a similar meter to Valmiki Ramayana. Classic there. The 300 Rakshasis are guarding Sita apparently in Ashoka Vanika, as per that Ramayana. 300 Rakshasis in 3 shifts. 100 for shipment. They are asking, they are all there, and Trijata is with them. But Trijata is the only one among them who comes to Sita's rescue, who gives her solace and keeps her occupied by playing games, etc. with her.
I wonder why Rakshasis didn't report her to
you. No, she is a senior person. She probably, Vibhishna's, she has certain
status.
Certain, she has certain privileges that other Rakshasis don't have.
Yeah.
And they know that, you know, who knows that that may be a role that Ravana has asked her to play. They get become Sita's friend.
Good cop, bad cop.
So, we don't know good cop, bad cop, as they say. So, the Rakshasi is not going to double this Ravana. They have to do their job, they're doing their job. Like that. So, she is a loyal friend, companion of Sita. And none of the, there was a European Jesuit priest actually, who came to India and he came to India and said, the Indians are all wanting to study English. He's too much, and he said, I study Hindi and all that. He studied the Indian language completely, thoroughly. Jesuit priest. His whole business is that. Can you understand the culture? He completely read the Ramayana. He did his PhD on Ramayana. And he did not find books on that. So he says in that, for more than 20 centuries, the poets who retold Rama's story have dealt lovingly on Trijata's friendship with Sita. Trijata conquered the hearts of these poets, and through them, the hearts of all those who became acquainted with the Rama story. The poets of Ramayana conferred on the humble Trijata the boon of immortality. No dream is better known in India than the dream of Trijata, who will live forever in the hearts of millions as the ideal of a true friend, because she comforted Sita in her darkest hour. There is a temple for Trijata. One in Kashi, one in Ujjain. In Kashi, next to Kashi Vishwanath temple. Apparently, after the war was over, she wanted to go to Ayodhya. This one story. In some story, she does go. Sita told her apparently that the Ayodhya, they won't allow Rakshasis. You don't think you go to Kashi. Kashi, Bhuta Gana, Shiva, Sita, Rakshi, no problem. Everyone can go. Smashana Bhumi. So you go to Ayodhya, you have to Varanasi. And then you will attain moksha. And you will worship as a goddess. Sita's blessing to Trijata. So there she's got a temple next to Kashi Vishwanath. Daily worship is offered every day. Green vegetable is offered to her, it seems, as Nivedyam. Green vegetable. You know, she wants it or not, but that's what they give her. The green and flowers and green vegetables. And the ladies, women who worship her at her shrine for 7 consecutive Wednesdays, like that, they have a thing there for Trijata. So if they don't have children, then the woman is supposed to worship there for 7 consecutive Wednesdays, you will have progeny, like that.
You are in distress also, you can worship.
Among other things. And many devotees, and the special time to go there is Kartik Purnima, that is Kartik Masal Purnima, that's not in the most temples, it's very. So, in fact, you go on Kartik Purnima, worship Vishwanath, and the next day, the first day of Margashisha month, you go and worship Trijata, then whatever prayer you have, that will, by the grace of Trijata, it will be fulfilled. There is a belief there in North India. Or you keep the fast of Kartik Mas, Vrat, and then you break that Vrat on the first day of Margashisha by taking the bath in Ashwamedh Ghat of Ganga and near Kashi Vishwanath temple, and break that, and then you have that bath and break the breath in the name of Trijata, then also. So these are some of the things that are beliefs, and there's a temple for her in Ujjain as well, in the Hanuman, one of the Hanuman temples there. So that was something about Trijata. She'll have a few more scenes in Ramayana. In Yuddhakandam she'll make very, very key scenes. She'll be very minimal. But she'll be very, very important information she'll pass on to Sita. Now, coming back to Ashokavanika. Now, the Jeta dream is over. Sita is in turmoil. A brief, commercial break kind of dream one. But that does not take the fact that Ravana has been threatening her 2 months only time, I'll kill Ratri, and the Rats is dancing around you saying, I'll eat you up, I'll eat you up, I'll eat you up. All that problem is there. She's not eating, drinking, she is in fast, all that. So yes, okay, little bit. But mind is mind. It's in deep depression. So like a dog's tail which you can straighten, it will go back like that. So mind again, she's back into her. She's remembering all the terrible things that Ravana had said before he left. And she's like a, Valmiki says, like a small cow, elephant in the forest. A small cow elephant is there and lion upon it. So how it will feel? Or lion roars nearby. Or like a small girl who suddenly finds herself left alone in the big forest. She's terrified. Like that she's feeling. And she's thinking that death will not come a moment earlier than what is destined. Otherwise, me with my entire heart filled to the brim with sorrow, like lightning hitting a mountain top and breaking it to 1,000 pieces. Why am I not being broken to 1,000 pieces? Why is my heart still working? Why is it beating? All that she's thinking and berating herself, saying, I have to commit suicide. I have to commit suicide. There's nothing wrong if I commit suicide. It is not a sin for me to commit suicide. Because even if I do not commit suicide, Ravana will kill me. I will die in his hand. I might as well take my own life and all that. He says, I have no doubt at all that this Ravana will. He will cut me to pieces like a barber would, apparently those days when a child had to be aborted, and the barber would be called, who will take a knife and abort the child. Like that he will do to me, she is thinking. And she is thinking, with 2 months, he's giving me 2 months time, but what is 2 months time? I mean, it is like for me, it is like the last night, the person is going to be hanged tomorrow, executed tomorrow, or last night before that execution. How it will feel? It's the same thing, it's no different. Alas Rama, alas Lakshmana, alas Sumitra, alas Rama's mother, I'm suffering, she's shouting. Like a ship caught in a hurricane, where is the hope for me? I'm sure that the princes have been killed. The princes Rama and Lakshmana, I'm sure they've been put to death by the deer. I have no doubt now all this whole thing happened because of me. I'm the one responsible. Like a pair of lions has been struck down by lightning, they have been killed. I'm sure they have been killed because of the bad luck that I am. I am only luck, bad luck, from head to foot. I brought death, not just to my... I was one luckless person who sent Rama behind the deer. And after that, I was one who sent his brother too. Because of me, all this has happened. And very beautiful conversation she has with herself. Where she is talking to Rama, and she's talking to Rama in 2-3 different ways. Rama the god, Rama the man, Rama the husband, like that. In her mind, and she says, Rama, O Rama of steadfast vows, O Rama, O you of long arm and face like the full moon. Rama who is loved by one and all, Rama who has only intent on the good for one and all creatures. Rama, you do not know that Ravana is going to kill me. Rama, I have looked upon you and you alone as my God. And I have put on with much trouble. I have borne much. I have slept on bare ground. I have disciplined myself in dharma. And I have been faithful to my husband. She is telling him, God Rama, that she has been faithful to her, being faithful to her husband Rama. You have been faithful to my husband. But all this has not availed me anymore. It's nothing, no use for me, it does not avail me any more than a good turn be done to an ungrateful person. Meaning to say that the husband Rama is ungrateful man. Ingrates among men. Fruitless has been the dharma that I have practiced, futile by vows of to my husband. I am, look at me, I am thin, pale and bereft of you, Rama. I have not set my eyes upon you and I have lost all hopes of being united with you. I faithfully, now about the man, husband, Rama, I faithfully will complete your vow to your father. Having faithfully completed your vow that you have given to your father, having obeyed your father's command, I am sure you will be happy going back to Ayodhya and enjoying your life with all the wide-eyed women. Untroubled by any fear, all your ambitions fulfilled. Tick, 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 done. But I, O Rama, having given you my love for long years, I shall be discarding my sorry life. All my fasting, all my vrata, all everything, nothing has brought me any good. I am a luckless creature. I should be happy to take any poison or use any sharp weapon and kill myself. But there is no one here who can help me. Having lamented like this long, her whole body trembling, her face parched, she went up to the tree which was in full flower. Her heart burning with grief. Sita, who already cannot help me saying even in this stage, that Sita, whose every limb was delicately fashioned, intensely brooding in her misery, she supported herself with a hand on one of the branches there, and she took her long hair in the other hand, looked at it. And she told herself, I'll hang myself with this. I shall hang myself with this plate around my neck and thus quickly reach Yama. Tasya suramam pravichintayantya ramanujam samchakulam shubhangya she shoka nimittani tatha bahuni धैर्याजिदानि प्रवराणि लोके प्रादुर्निमित्तान् तदा बभूव पुरापि सिद्धानि बलक्षितानि. So what she do? She decided to hang herself by her own hair. It's wrong, thick, dark, doable. And last moment, she's bringing her mind again. She thinks about Rama, she thinks about Lakshmana. And she thinks about her own family, Janaka and all that, before she is going to hang herself. And then suddenly she sees many good omens. And these omens indicate the end of her sorrows. And this, suddenly these omens seeing this, these are omens. She knew from experience, she knew from before, this means good thing is going to happen. Purapi siddhani parakshitani. Such omens are always indicated imminent good fortune. So suddenly she saw some omens which suddenly filled her with courage. On that note, we'll conclude here today. Hara Namah Parvati Pate Janaki Kanta Smaranam
Jai Jai Rama Rama
Gopika Jeevana Smaranam
Govinda Govinda
Kativel Murganakya
Haranadogara
Sadguru Swaminah
Jai
Sri Anjaneya Swaminah
Jai.
Two things. One is this next chapter which is called good fortune. Shivanivetani. Small one. It is read, people are in great misery and suffering. They are advised to read this chapter. Small chapter. Next one.
She is ready to hang herself.
So, that is one. Two. The second thing is, she is coming to the very tree where Hanuman is sitting to hang herself. The tree is in full flower. He has to look carefully at the tree. She has come there. Then this happens. But we know another important point is Trijata has, in her dream, she also saw a monkey, the Vasindhara of Rama, burning Lanka. That was not in his project plan. He had not thought of that. So in some sense, he was given that this needs to be done too. So then he knows that one more thing, is important thing is left to be done. So that is a...
He connected it to Trijata's dream. He just did what he had to do.
No, he may have well connected. I mean, we have decided that this has been seen. And so, he is sitting in the tree. Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa told the gospel of Sri Ramakrishna written by M. Mahendranath Gupta. He said that one day you will go and you will embrace Puri Jagannath. Mahendranath Gupta, who will allow him to enter the sanctum sacrum of Puri Jagannath? Pandas will, you can't. How will you do that? Well, you can't enter the sanctum sacrum of Puri Jagannath. Garbhagraham, go and hug the Jagannath. Ramakrishna told you. He said, my master said, I have to do it. How he did it, I'll tell you, but first I'll stop the recording.